I'm standing on the parking lot at Twin Pines Mall. It's Saturday morning, October 26, 1985, 1:18 a.m., and this is temporal experiment number one. Come on, Einy. Hey, boy, get in there. That a boy. In you go. Get down. Get your seatbelt on. That's it.
Whoa. Okay.
Please note that Einstein's clock is in precise synchronization with my control watch. Got it?
Right. Check, Doc.
Good. Have a good trip, Einstein. Watch your head.
You got that thing hooked up to the car?
Watch this.
Yeah, okay. Got it.
Not me. The car. The car. If my calculations are correct, when this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're gonna see some serious shit. Watch this.
Gonna work? Don't let the ramshackle nature of my laboratory fool you. If all goes according to plan, we'll soon be in possession of the most powerful rocket fuel known to man.
That's great. How?
Well, it's very simple.
Aha! Got it!
Got what?
I'll show you!
Ready to go, Einstein?
Watch this!
Baby hits 23 miles per hour. We're gonna stop. Serious count.
I'm working out most every day and watching what I eat.
This crankshaft induces a powerful direct current into the electrolysis chamber, producing hydrogen, which must be periodically released into the primary distillation barrel.
Einstein, get him out of there.
Tending to the hydrogen will also need a regularly sprinkled these shredded protein flakes into this aquarium of super bacteria to generate the necessary nitrogen to catalyze the reaction.
Cool.
Oh, hot! Extremely hot! Come on, start! I've got a fail-safe eject mechanism around here someplace.
See?
Nothing to worry about.
Nothing.
The temperature of the reaction must be kept at a steady temperature of 622 degrees Kelvin by carefully pumping these bubbles. Any questions?
Everywhere.
God, if I were you, it's through amazing the world. Hi. The rocket fuel experiment must have stripped one of the teeth in the hand crank. As a consequence, if you turn it for more than 10 seconds, it sends out an electric shock.